The Spanish colonial period in the Philippines was the period during which the Philippines were part of Spanish Empire as the Captaincy General of the Philippines from 1565 to 1898.
The Battle in Manila, 1570. Ito ay nangyari sa Manila between the native Filipinos at saka ng mga Spaniard. Ang mga Pilipino ay pinamunuan ni Raja Sulaiman at ang mga Espanyol naman ay pinamunuan ni Martin de Goiti at Maestre de Ocampo noong May 24, 1570. The forces of Goiti is victorious. Sila yung nanalo. So, ang nangyari ay naging capital ng Spanish East Indies ang Manila. In late 1560s, Miguel Lopez de Legazpi, who had left Mexico, is searching for more suitable place. So, ibig sabihin, 1560s pa lang, naghahanap na si Miguel Lopez de Legazpi ng magandang lugar na tatayuan ng capital ng Spanish colony. Then nakarinig siya about sa isang karapat-dapat na lugar, and that is Manila. So si Legazpi ay nag-send ng message sa king ng lugar na ito na si Raja Matanda, also known as the King of the Luzon. And then Legazpi sent Martin de Goiti upang mamuno sa expedition papuntang Manila at para doon ay magtayo ng kampo nila. De Goiti arrived in May 1570 anchored in Cavite on the mouth of the Manila Bay. He was initially well received by Manila's ruler, Raja Matanda, who as a former commander of a naval forces of Sultanate of Brunei had already dealings with Magellan expedition in late 1521. So, anong nangyari? The negotiation broke down when another ruler, Raja Sulaiman, arrived and began treating the Spanish belligerently, saying that the Tagalog people would not surrender their freedom as easily as fated at ginawa ng Bisaya. So, sabi ni Raja Sulaiman, hindi nila ibibigay yung Manila katulad ng ginawa ng mga Bisaya. So, by May 24, na-break yung negotiation, and according to the Spanish accounts, their ship fired their cannon as the signal for the expedition boats to return. Nag-signal daw sila ng pagputok ng kanyon para umalis na yung mga ship nila na nakadaong malapit sa Manila. But the Manila is an attack. Yung mga sabi ni Sir Sulaiman ordered the attack on the Spanish forces still within the city. The battle was very brief because it concluded with settlement of Manila being set ablaze. So, ibig sabihin, sobrang natalo yung Manila. Sa mga panahon na yun, hindi maintindihan kung sino talaga yung una nagpaputok. Kung nagpaputok ba talaga yung mga Spaniards or gusto lang talaga mambanat ng mga Pilipino sa Maynila. So, De Goiti proclaimed victory kahit na anong nangyari, kung sino mang nauna sa kanilang sumugod or nagbigay ng intensyon para sa gera na yon. Ang nanalo ay sa ang mga Espanyol. Symbolically, claim Maynila on behalf of Spain that quickly returned to Legazpi because he knew that his naval forces were outnumbered. So, kinlaim ni De Goiti na sa kanila na ang Manila. Our country as a colony of Spain. During most of colonial period, the Philippine economy depended on the galleon trade, which was inaugurated in 1565 between Manila and Acapulco. Then, the Viceroyalty of New Spain, trade between Philippines and Spain, was via the Pacific Ocean to New Mexico. And then, across the Atlantic Ocean to Spain, Manila became a major center of trade in Asia between the 17th century and 18th century. All sorts of products from China, Japan, Brunei, the Moluccas, and even India were sent to Manila to be sold in exchange for Spanish silvers or 8 real coins which came abroad the galleons from Acapulco. These goods including silk, porcelain, spices, and textile products were then sent to Acapulco and from there to other parts of New Spain, Peru, and Europe. And then, the European population in the archipelago steadily grew, although native Filipinos remained the majority. After that daw, nung mga panahon na yon, dumadami na yung mga Espanyol dito sa bansa. Pero lamang pa din naman ang Pilipino. Manila was settled by 1,200 Spanish families. In Cebu at the Visayas, the settlement received a total of 2,100 soldiers, yung mga sundalong Espanyol. At the immediate south of Manila, Mexican were present at Ermita and at Cavite where they stationed as sentries. So sila yung mga bantay doon sa mga ano, sa Cavite and sa south of Manila, where they stationed as sentries. In that settled Zamboanga City in Mindanao to wage war upon Muslim defenders, meron din sa Mindanao para doon sa mga Muslim na nagde-defend ng buong bansa. So, sabi doon, sabi rin dito na ang bansa natin is the naging sentro ng trade sa halos sa buong mundo dahil sa mga Espanyol when nung nasakop nila tayo as their colonists.
According to the research that I gather about central government under Spain, Spain established one central government in the Philippines. Thus, for the first time in our history, we became united as one nation called Filipinas. Philippine territory in Spain. There are differences in the territory ruled by central government. First, the island archipelagos of Guam, the Marinos, Caroline, and the Palaus in the South Pacific were included in the Philippines territory during Spanish times. Second, most of Mindanao and Cebu were excluded. Third, interior mountain regions of Luzon and Visayas were excluded.
The Philippines as a colony of Spain. During Spain's 333-year rule in the Philippines, the settlers had to fight off the Chinese pirates. Dutch forces, Portuguese forces, and indigenous revolts. Moros from Western Mindanao and the Sulu Archipelago also raided the coastal Christian areas of Luzon and the Visayas. Some Japanese ships visited the Philippines in the 1570s in order to export Japanese silver and import Philippine gold. Later, increasing imports of silver from New World sources resulted in Japanese exports to the Philippines shifting from silver to consumer goods. In the 1570s, the Spanish traders were troubled to some extent by Japanese pirates, but peaceful trading relations were established between the Philippines and Japan by 1590. Japan Kampaku Toyotomi Hideyoshi demanded unsuccessfully on several occasions that the Philippines submit to Japan. On February 8, 1597, King Philip II, near the end of his 42-year reign, issued a royal cedula instructing Francisco de Tello de Guzman, then Governor General of the Philippines, to fulfill the laws of tributes and to provide for restitution of ill-gotten taxes taken from indigenous Filipinos. The decree was published in Manila on August 5, 1598. King Philip died on September 13, just 40 days after the publication of the decree. But his death was not known in the Philippines until middle of 1599, by which time a referendum by which indigenous Filipinos would acknowledge Spanish rule was underway. With the completion of the Philippine referendum of 1599, Spain could be said to have established legitimate sovereignty over the Philippines. During the Spanish colonization, remaining monarchs reigned until their kingdoms was absorbed to the new colonial nation of the Philippines through Spanish conquest. Many of these territories are absorbed much later. Raja Colombo is the king of Limasawa in 1521, brother of Raja Shagu of Butuan. He befriended Portuguese explorer Ferdinand Magellan and guided him to Cebu on April 7, 1521. Raja Humabon is king of Cebu, who became an ally of Ferdinand Magellan and the Spaniards. Rival of Datu Lapu-Lapu, in 1521, he and his wife were baptized as Christians and gave Christian name Carlos and Juana after the Spanish royalty King Carlos and Queen Juana. Sultan Kudarat, Sultan of Maguindanao, Lacandula or Lacandula, King of Tondo, one of the last prince of Manila. Datu Lapu-Lapu is the king of Mactan Island. He defeated the Spaniards on April 27, 1521. Datu Sikatuna was the king of Bohol in 1565. He made a blood compact with the Spanish explorer Miguel Lopez de Legazpi. Datu Pagbuwaya, king of Bohol. He governed with his brother Datu Dailisan, a settlement along the shorelines between Mansasa, Tagbilaran, and Dawis, which was abandoned years before the Spanish colonization due to Portuguese internecine attacks. He founded the Pitan in the northern shore of Mindanao. Datu Dailisan, king of Mansasa, Tagbilaran, and Dawis, and governed their kingdom along with his brother Datu Pagbuwaya. His death during one of the Portuguese raids caused abandonment of the settlement. Datu Manuok, Christian name Pedro Manuel Manuok, son of Datu Pagbuwaya, who converted to Christianity, defeated the Higaonon tribe in Iligan, Mindanao. He established one of the first Christian settlements in the country. Datu Makabulos, king of Pampanga in 1571. Raja Shagu, king of Manobo in 1521. Aponowan, chieftain of Mandani. Apo Makarere, famous chieftain of the Tagbanwa warrior tribe in Korong Island. Raja Sulaiman III, one of the last king of Manila, was defeated by Martin de Goiti, Spanish soldier commissioned by Lopez de Legazpi to Manila. Raja Tupas, king of Cebu, conquered by Miguel Lopez de Legazpi. Datu Urduha, female leader in Pangasinan. Datu Sula, chieftain of Mactan, Cebu rival of Lapu-Lapu. Datu Kalun, ruler of island in the Basilan and Dayacans in Mindanao, converted his line to Christianity. Datu Sanday, ruler of Marawi City. Datu Saiden Borero, king of Antique, unnamed Datu, King of Taytay Palawan, mentioned by Pigafetta, Chronicler of Magellan. The king, together with his wife, were kidnapped by the remnant troops from Magellan's fleet after fleeing Cebu to secure provision for their crossing to the Moluccas. And last, Datu Caballo, the last king of the kingdom of Taytay. In 1565, Spanish Governor General Miguel Lopez de Legazpi claimed the Philippines as a Spanish colony and designated Manila as its capital in 1571. Due to its distance from Spain, the Spanish government assigned Manila's administration and government to the Viceroyalty of New Spain for 2.5 centuries. Evangelization and commercialization constituted the core of intercontinental ties between Asia and America that materialized with the Manila-Acapulco-Galleon Strait. Due to the grand exchange with the Philippines in those days, many cultural traits were adopted by one another. With Mexican remaining in the Philippines and Filipinos establishing in Mexico, particularly the central west coast near the port town of Acapulco, many Nahu words were adopted and popularized in the Philippines, such as Tiangu, market pear, and Sapote, a fruit. The Philippines was built as a Spanish colony in 1565 when Miguel Lopez de Legazpi was appointed Governor General. He selected Manila as the capital in 1571. The island were very remote, so the Spanish royal family commissioned the Philippine government administration to the Viceroyalty of New Spain based in Mexico for over 2.5 centuries. Hence, many of the Filipino governors were Mexican Creole. The army was recruited from all the population of New Spain, which led to ethnic and cultural mingling between Mexicans and Filipinos. Evangelization and commerce connected America and Asia, exemplified by the Galleon Trade. The trade between Canton and Acapulco passed through Manila, where Chinese ships came laden with silks and porcelain to be sent to America in exchange for silver, and the exchange of ideas accompanied the exchange of products.
Narito ang kompletong listahan ng mga pagkakasunod-sunod ng mga naging gobernador ng Pilipinas simula ng taong 1565 hanggang 1899. Miguel Lopez de Legazpi, Guido de Labasares, Dr. Francisco de Sande, Gonzalo Ronquillo de Peñalosa, Diego Ronquillo, Dr. Santiago de Vera, Gomez Perez das Marinas, Licenciate Pedro de Rojas, Luis Perez das Marinas, Francisco de Telio de Guzman, Pedro Bravo de Acuña, Rodrigo de Vivero, Juan de Silva, Alfonso Fajardo y Tenza, Fernando de Silva, Juan Nino de Tabora, Juan Cerezo de Salamanca, Sebastián Hurtado de Corcuera, Diego Fajardo, Sabiniano Manrique de Lara, Diego de Salcedo, Juan Manuel de la Peña Bonifaz, Juan de León, Juan de Vargas Hurtado, Gabriel de Curuzeliegui y Arriola, Fausto Cruzat y Gongora, Domingo Salvaburo de Echevarri, Martin de Orsúa y Arismendi, Fernando Manuel de Bustillo Bustamante y Rueda, Fray Francisco de la Cuesta, Toribio Jose Concho y Campo, Fernando Valdez y Tamon, Gaspar de la Torre, Fray Juan Arequedera, José Francisco de Obando y Solis, Pedro Manuel de Arandía Santisteban, Miguelino de Espeleta, Manuel Rojo, Simón de Anda y Salazar, Francisco Javier de la Torre, José Raón, Simón de Anda y Salazar, Pedro Sarre, Jose Vasco y Vargas, Pedro de Sario, Felix Berger de Marquina, Rafael Maria de Aguilar y Ponce de Leon, Mariano Fernandez de Folgueras, Manuel Gonzalez de Aguilar, Jose Gardolgi Jarabetía, Mariana Fernandez de Folgueras, Juan Antonio Martinez, Mariana Ricafort Balasin y Ararca, Pascual Enrile y Alcedo, Gabriel de Torres, Juan Kramer, Pedro Antonio Salazar Castillo y Varona, Andres García Camba, Luis Lardizabal, Marcelino de Oraa Lecumberi, Francisco de Paula Alcala de la Torre, Narciso Claveria y Zaldúa, Antonio María Blanco, Antonio de Orbistodo y Eguía, Ramón Montero y Blandino, Manuel Pavia y Lai, Ramón Montero y Blandino, Manuel Crespo y Cerebría, Ramón Montero y Blandino, Fernando Nortzargaray y Escudero, Ramón María Solano y Lianderal, Juan Herrera Davila, Jose Lemery y Ibarola Ney y González, Salvador Valdez, Rafael de Echague y Birmingham, Joaquín del Solar y Ibanez, Juan de la y Irogen, Jose Laureano y Sanz y Pose, Antonio Osorio, Joaquín del Solar, Jose de la Gandara y Navarro, Manuel Moldanado, Carlos María de la Torre y Navac Serrada, Rafael de Izquierdo y Gutierrez, Manuel Macrojon, Juan Alaminos y De Vivar, Manuel Blanco Valderrama, Jose Malcampo y Monje, Domingo Moriones y Murillo, Rafael Rodriguez Arias, Fernando Primo de Rivera, Emilio Molins, Joaquín Jovelar, Emilio Molins, Emilio Terrero y Perenat, Antonio Molto, Federico Lobaton, Valeriano Wheeler, Eulogio Despujol, Federico Ochando, Ramon Blanco, Camilo Polavieja, Jose de la Cambre, Fernando Primo de Rivera, Basilio Agustin, Fermin Huaden, Francisco Rizzo, Diego de los Ríos.
Islands were part of the larger Spanish East Indies. 44 years after Ferdinand Magellan landed in the Philippines and died in the Battle of Mactan in 1521. The Spanish explored and colonized the islands, starting with the founding of Cebu by Miguel Lopez de Legazpi in 1565. Manila was made the capital of made Philippines in 1571. The Catholic Church in the Philippines, Filipino, Simbang Katoliko sa Pilipinas, Spanish, Iglesia Católica en las Filipinas, is part of the Worldwide Catholic Church, under the spiritual direction of the Pope. The Philippines is one of the two nations in Asia having substantial portion of the population professing the Catholic faith along with the East Timor, and has the third largest Catholic population in the world after Brazil and Mexico. The Episcopal Conference responsible in the governing the faith in the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.